So hello, in this video I am going to walk you through how to do Fischer projections from wedge and dash projections. So let's start with our first example, which is very easy, so that you understand the principle, and then later we'll do more complicated examples. What you need to understand when we do Fischer projections is two things. When I draw a vertical line in a Fischer projection, I am representing parts of a molecule that are facing away from me. While when I draw a horizontal line, I am representing parts of a molecule that are facing towards me. Okay? Now, together with my third rule, this will make drawing Fischer projections very easy. What I always suggest you do is that you make these solid lines right here in a molecule become the vertical line. To say it more clearly, we always want these solid lines to be facing away from me. So I will make them my vertical line. Let me write CH2, CH3, CH3, and now I need to look at this molecule in a way that these solid lines are facing away from me. The only way to do this is for me to stand here. I'm standing here, very happy to be drawing Fischer projections, and I'm looking at the molecule in this way. The solid lines are facing away from me, and hydrogen and bromine are facing towards me. They create my horizontal line. The only thing I need to decide is which is on the right and which is on the left. I think in this example it's very easy to see, but anyway, there's a simple rule we can follow. When there's a wedge is always coming out of a page, towards me, it's closer to me. When there is a dash, the dash is going into the page, it's more in the background, away from me. So if I redraw this, the molecule looks something like this. I have hydrogen on the left, and I have bromine on the right. And here is the rest of the molecule with carbon in the middle. I think with this perspective, it's very obvious to see that bromine is on the left side and hydrogen on the right. Okay? So this was the first example, and now we'll do some more complicated problems. Okay, so in the second problem, we have a slightly bigger molecule. Perhaps you're thinking, what do I do? The first problem was so easy, but now I just don't know what to do. Let's just follow the rules we already mentioned. So first we look at this part of the molecule. I already told you that the solid lines are going to make our vertical line. So let's just draw a vertical line. I don't need to worry about the horizontal line here, because there are no wedges and dashes, so I can just put it on the top. COOH. Then I am going to worry about the second carbon, this carbon, which is going to create my horizontal line. And then I have this third carbon, which has three hydrogens. And once again, we don't need to worry about it. What we need to worry about is the amino group, which can be either on the left side or on the right side. And what I suggest you always do is to try to draw the hydrogen, which we normally don't do, but I think it will help. And now once again, we need to realize that the solid lines, just for this carbon, not for the whole molecule because we cannot do that, need to face away from me. The only way to do this is for me to stand here and look at it this way. And now just remember that the wedges are coming out of the page, they are closer to me, the dashes are going into the page, more away from me. So if you imagine yourself standing somewhere here in the middle, you can see that the amino group is on the left and the hydrogen is on the right. If you cannot see it, I will try to rotate this for you so it's more obvious. So I think if you once again remind yourself wedge out of the page, dash into the page, you can see that the amino group is on the left. So this was the second problem. Now let's do something even more difficult. Okay, so this is our third problem, and I think that you are going to find this very similar to the problem we've just done. So, we are once again going to make these solid lines our vertical line, and I will count the number of carbons. 1, 2, 3, and 4, okay? So I can put COH on the top. There are no wedges or dashes, so I don't need to worry about them. And then I will put the horizontal line here. This is where the OH group is going to be located. I just don't know if it will be on the right or on the left yet. Then I can draw a horizontal line for the third carbon. In a second I'll explain why we don't need to do it, but for now let's just draw the line. And then for the fourth carbon I can just put CH3 here. But if you think about the third carbon again, it has two hydrogens, right? And we don't care which is on the left and which is on the right. So we can redraw this and write COH for the second carbon. And then CH2 for the third carbon and CH3 for the fourth carbon. And now we will just figure out the position of the OH group. So, the same rule as always, the solid lines need to be facing away from me, so I am going to position myself right here, looking at them like this, so that they are facing away from me. And I am going to draw the hydrogen for us. And once again, a wedge is going out of the page, a dash into the page, more in the background. So if I rotate this for you, and hopefully I can rotate this correctly, it looks like this. And we can see that the OH group is on the right and the hydrogen is on the left because the wedge is going out of the page. Okay, so a very easy problem. Let's do something more complicated. Okay, so this is a more complicated problem, but in principle we are still doing the same things over and over again. So I will start from the beginning, marking the carbons 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I can already tell that carbon number 1 has 2 hydrogens and carbon number 5 has 1 hydrogen. And because there are no wedges, dashes, we can just write CHOH, okay? CH2OH. Then we'll draw a horizontal line for carbon number 2, 3, 4. And then I just write CHO, okay? And now we just make sure that for each individual carbon, we are in a position with the solid lines facing away from us. So for the second carbon, I need to stay here, right? Solid lines, these two facing away from me. I can draw the hydrogen for us, and now you can see OH going out of the page, hydrogen into the page. So OH is on the left, hydrogen on the right. Moving to the third carbon, let's draw the hydrogen. And I have to stand here, right? So that the solid lines are facing away from me. And with the hydrogen going out of the page, I can see it's on the right side, while the OH group is on the left. And finally, I am going to stand here, looking at it this way, so that these solid lines are facing away from me. And I will draw the hydrogen here, and I can see that this OH group is once again on my left, with the hydrogen going into the page on my right. If you need to, take some time, redraw this, and I think you should come to the same conclusion as I have, okay? Once again, nothing complicated. We just need to realize that for our carbon number 1 and 4, we don't need to do anything. So I'm just going to write COOH, horizontal line for carbon 2, carbon 3, and then once again COOH. Now, the perspective. So solid lines going away from me like this. I will draw the hydrogen. Sorry, this isn't the best drawing, but if you once again remember hydrogen going out of the page, OH into the page, you will realize OH is on the right and hydrogen on the left, okay? Changing our perspective, let me draw this a little bit better. So solid lines facing away from me, and I can see hydrogen going out of the page, so it's on my right, OH on my left. And this is it. So let's do the last problem. Okay, so I think that you are going to find this very easy now. Counting the carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. For carbon 1 and 5, we don't need to do anything. So I'm just going to write COOH and then CHO. And now carbon number 2, 3, and 4. Solid lines facing away from me, this perspective. Okay? Hydrogen going out of the page to my left, OH going into the page to my right. Okay? Next one. Solid lines facing away from me, hydrogen going out of the page to my right, amino group into the page to my left. And the final carbon, let me just draw this hydrogen here. Solid lines going away from me, the OH group going out of the page, it's closer to me, so it's on my left, and the hydrogen to my right going into the page. Okay? And this is it. So when I first started drawing Fischer projections, I thought it was awfully complicated and I found it so confusing, but now I think that you can just follow these very simple rules, go over the problems again, and you'll find that actually it's quite easy to do.